Hello guys, in this video I would be reviewing the Oneplus 5. So let's just see what the things we get in the box. First of all, we get the phone itself. I'll just keep the phone aside and check all other things that we get in the box. Here we get a quick startup guide and a SIM ejector tool, as you can see. And this is the photo which is kicked by Oneplus. It is the dash charger and the USB type C cable. So let's just keep the things aside and let's have a look at the phone. First of all, talking about the build quality and the physical overview, this phone is a premium phone which is made of unimetal body. The whole body is made of metal and it's very slim phone, as you can see, and very lightweight also. Coming to the physical overview, in the front it has a 5.5 inch Super AMOLED display. Here is the fingerprint scanner and there are the touch capacitive buttons. Here is the earpiece of the phone and the primary camera. To the right side, here we have the lock button, here we have the slim slots. You can insert two nano SIM cards here. Okay, and on the left side we have the alert slider. I would show you the alert slider. You push it up, it goes to do not disturb and then goes to silent. So there are three modifications you can do as per your requirements. And here are the volume rocker buttons, the up volume and the down volume. If you go to the bottom, here you get the speaker of the phone, the main speaker. Here you get the USB type C port for charging and data syncing. And here is the 3.5 mm headphone jack with a microphone. And at the top, there is nothing. Coming to the back, it has a dual camera setup with an LED flash and the Oneplus logo. So, coming back to the specification of the phone, comes with a Snapdragon 835 processor, which is the latest processor. It is an octa-core processor with an Adreno 530 running on the latest Android 7.1.1. I will just show you the latest Android version. As you can see, it is running on the latest Android 7.1.1, and it comes with two variants, that is the 6GB RAM variant and the 8GB RAM variant. The 6GB RAM variant comes with a 64GB of internal storage, whereas the 8GB RAM variant comes with a 128GB of internal storage. Here I am having the 6GB variant, which is having 64GB of internal storage. And it has all the necessary sensors. There is a fingerprint sensor, proximity sensor, accelerometer, gyroscope sensor and compass. Talking about the battery, it comes with a 3300 mAh battery, which is last up to a day, and the battery performance is very good as compared to the many other flagship killers in the market. And it also comes with a dash charger, as I have shown you the dash charger, so it can charge the phone within an hour. So within an hour your phone will be fully charged. And this phone is available in three colors. That is the slate gray version, which I am having here. Another is the midnight black edition, which is only available in 8GB RAM model. And another is the soft gold variant. And coming to the camera of this phone, here is phone wise the flagship killer, because it has a very good camera, that is a dual camera setup. The first camera is a 16MP camera, which is having a 1.7 aperture, and second is the 20MP camera, that is a telephoto lens, which is having f2.6 aperture, and it is having a dual LED flash, and the camera is capable of recording videos up to 4K, and it also has an electronic image stabilization, which is capable of recording videos till 1080p. Okay, and talking about the front camera, it has a 16MP front camera with f2.2 aperture. These are some of the camera samples that are clicked in the depth mode, as you can see in the portrait mode. You can see you get a nice bokeh effect as you get in the DSLR. So the photo quality is pretty good of Oneplus as compared to the many other flagship killers in the market, like Samsung Galaxy Note 8 or Google Pixel. So it's a very good phone at a very great price. The photos are pretty clear and pretty crisp. The color saturation is also good in the photos, as you can see. These are some of the normal photos that are not taken in the depth mode, like the normally with a primary lens. This photo is clicked by a primary lens.
that is 16 megapixel, and on the same angle it is clicked in the telephoto lens, that is 20 megapixel. These are some of the indoor photos in the indoor lighting condition. As you can see, the photo quality is very good in indoor lighting condition. Also, the camera performs very good on both the conditions. These are some of the photos that are clicked from front camera, that is a 16 megapixel. The front camera also performs very good. And this is the video which is recorded at 1080p. As you can see, the video quality is very good. The autofocus is also very good. As you can see, the colors are very vibrant in the video also.
Let me just show you the video quality of this phone. I would just play some video so you can see the screen quality of the phone. How good is this screen quality? And the audio quality also. You can see the viewing angles are also very good. It's a full HD video I am playing here. Okay, this was the screen quality and the audio quality. The screen is 5.5 inch full Super AMOLED display. As you can see, the viewing angles are pretty good and it's a pretty good screen. For the screen protection, there is Gorilla Glass 5, which is the latest Gorilla Glass variant. So it's very good to have all these things, and this phone is available in the market for price of 32,999. So it's a flagship killer, as you can see. And coming back to the gaming performance, we would just check some of the gaming performance. I would just open a game and we will see the gaming performance. It's not lagging. The I played the thumbnails of a game. It's pretty smooth also, as you can see, and the quality for the game also is very good. As you have seen, the gaming quality was very good, and I would just now show you some multitasking, like how the RAM management goes in the OnePlus 5. I would just open some of the apps and show you how seamlessly and fast all the apps are in the multitasking also. As you can see, I have opened a lot of apps, so let me just open this app. Yeah, as you can see, the app is not reloading. Like if I jump from one app to the another, it's not reloading, it's the same. So the RAM management is pretty good, and you can also do multitasking here by having a multi-window option. As you can see, I can run both the apps seamlessly and very flawlessly, very smooth experience the OnePlus 5 has. And talking about the security, has a fingerprint scanner, also has a face recognition. I have set up a face recognition. I will just show you where you can set up. In the security, there you go to smart lock, and in smart lock there is an option of trust face. So I have set it up a face recognition. I will just show you. If I do not see to the phone, I cannot unlock, so I have to put the pattern to unlock. But if I see to the phone, as you can see, the phone is unlocked. So this is how the face recognition works. So that's it for the review, guys. If you have any questions regarding to this review, you can just comment down below in the comment section, and please do share, subscribe and like the video. Thank you for watching, guys.